This video will go over the basics of an abdominal exam on a patient. So first, I'm always going to start off by inspection. I'm going to be looking for any scars. You know, an appendectomy scar is going to be at McBurney's point approximately, and just looking for any distension or any ascites. This is a mannequin that is apparently healthy, so there is going to be nothing wrong with inspection. So next, I always go on to palpation. For palpation, you're going to divide the abdomen into four different quadrants. So starting with the umbilicus, that's going to be my middle point. I'm going to draw four imaginary lines. So everything up here is going to be the right upper quadrant, the left upper quadrant, the left lower, and the right lower quadrants. So the organs that are going to be found in each is the right upper is going to contain primarily the gallbladder and liver, while the left upper is primarily going to be the spleen. The right lower is going to be your appendix, which is going to be at McBurney's point. So we find your ASIS, your umbilicus, draw an imaginary line between the two. Apparently two-thirds down is going to be about McBurney's point, and that's going to be your appendix. Also, you've got your ascending colon, and your descending colon is going to be on here and turn into the sigmoid and then go into your rectum. So let's start with palpation. What I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be making little circles that are going to be light, about a centimeter deep. Next, I'm going to apply a little deeper pressure, so I'm at least 2 or 3 centimeters deep into the abdomen. I'm going to do this in a few different locations within each quadrant. And make sure you go on to all four quadrants. It shouldn't be painful to the patient. You always want to forewarn them that they will have a little bit of pressure, especially as you go into the deeper palpations. So all light and deep palpations seem to be normal. Next, I like to go on to checking the liver and the spleen size during the abdominal exam. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to find the inferior costal margin, which is going to be the bottom of the rib cage. I'm going to place my hand right below. I'd add a little bit of pressure, so that way I can feel some traction down into the stomach, and then ask the patient, can I have you take a deep breath in? What that's going to do is, by me placing my fingers here, right underneath the margins, it's going to bring the diaphragm down when the lungs expand, and that causes the liver to be pushed up against my hands. A typical liver is felt through palpation this way, but it should not be excessively large. Likewise, I do the same over here to the spleen in the left upper quadrant. Spleen should not be palpable unless if the patient has an enlarged spleen. Maybe you'd feel a little bit, but it should not be prominent under your fingertips, especially during inhalation. Next, I'm going to move on to percussion. And for percussion, you can either use your fingers as a hammer, or I prefer the hammer for percussion. And again, you're going to want to do percussion in all four quadrants in a few variety of locations. Again, this should not be painful for the patient. Next, I'm going to go on to auscultation. And for auscultation, what I'll be doing is I'll be listening all four quadrants for active bowel sounds. All bowel sounds are present, which means I can move on. If you did not hear bowel sounds in any of the four quadrants, then you would want to hold your stethoscope there for at least 5 minutes to confirm your diagnosis of a non-working intestine. So next I'm going to move on to auscultation of the abdominal aorta. To find the abdominal aorta, I'm going to find the umbilicus and move slightly left of the umbilicus. I personally like to use the bell because it can help pick up the aortic sound.